It is 1:40 a.m. at the foot of the Reek and the rain is battering down. Now is the peak hour. People are arriving by bus and car, and it's only 100 minutes into Donab Crum Dubh, the last Sunday of July, National Pilgrimage Day to Ireland's holy mountain, Croagh Patrick. These people are some of the 15,000 who in a period of 14 hours will have hauled themselves to the top to follow in Patrick's penitential path. The prophets of penance, sticks for the reek. But they are essential for a treacherous climb on a dirty night. The cost varies with demand and the time of night, up to 1 and 6 each. Not bad when a man can sell up to 1,000. Some pilgrims take 2, so perhaps 25,000 will be sold before first light. Another price for pilgrimage, a reminder of the rigors of the reek. There's a strange mood of reverence and revelry, penance and profit here. No real aura of piety. Perhaps in the knowledge of what's ahead, this is the only way. It could be football or a flower, but the lights twinkle high in the inky blackness, beckoning. Rosary beads and chalky gods, bring them up for a blessing, if you can carry them. The rain still beats down. Traditionally, it rains for the reek, but this, according to most, is the worst night for years. To these two, bare-chested, a wet, chilling prospect of a climb. To their credit, they made it to the very top. Croagh Patrick, I recall, 2,510 feet high. A loping, gradual climb, almost 3 miles from base to peak. It will take us 3 hours to the top. Even now, some are returning from midnight mass at the top. It's very much an all-night vigil. A vigil of pain and endurance. A recollection so many pilgrims told us of the roots of their religion. Christianity and the cross, the suffering Irish. For 1,100 years, men and women have climbed Croagh Patrick with a primitive purging faith. Once it was an imposed penance. Today it grows as a voluntary exercise in the mortification of the flesh. Call it melodramatic or masochistic, no one who has ever climbed is untouched by it. The statue of St. Patrick, the first unofficial station. 7 times round, Padres and Aves to the prescribed numbers. Pursuit of a legend. Folklore has it Patrick climbed the mountain and fasted for 40 days and 40 nights in the tradition of Elias, Moses and Christ. But no one knows for sure. More likely it's a Christianization of a pagan tradition of Lunasa, a festival celebrated on heights marking the end of summer and the beginning of harvest. But the origins no longer matter. It's now very much a personal pilgrimage. Lunasa was a peasant festival. Croagh Patrick's appeal is still largely to the people of the country. Old-time religion, encouraged at a time when Catholicism was proscribed, with a plenary indulgence for the climbers from 1661. It has been built into tradition, unaffected by change or sophistication, oddly bigger this year than before. the summit. Mass at the top is for most an essential part of the pilgrimage. From 4 o'clock to noon, a constant celebration, the sacrifice underlined. For the local church to encourage the climb, supporting facts. Nearly 9,000 communicants, almost as many confessions. These statistics of faith. But what about real Christianity over the year? It's ethereal at the top, damp under the cloud and bitterly cold. A grey dawn. The climb down, more difficult and dangerous. One serious injury. The Order of Malta had 25 units, in all 230 workers from all over Ireland on the mountain. They treated 126 casualties, seven of whom were admitted to the county hospital in Castlebar with serious injuries, including fractures. Two are still there. It was a tougher climb than most years, and the order won the highest respect for its shuttle service through the pilgrimage hours. But again, inevitably, the question, why? What is Croagh Patrick's real meaning? A penitential exercise? Or a physical challenge? A tradition? Or as one put it to me, a way to pass the night? It is easy to be cynical, yet difficult to forget the suffering and the sincerity. But is this simply a few hours of penance, living faith, Irish style, for a day?